So we thought about, well, how could you empower the kids to bring a sense of hope and a sense of color back to this community when the whole town is destroyed? So we had this little idea, well, what if they paint words or designs or expressions on wooden stars, and then we'll plant the stars in every single corner of the town with these green poles. So what happens is when you have tragedies like this, and after the news cameras leave and sometimes the volunteers go back home, people are left for months and years sort of staring at where their homes used to be, and it's really hard for them to deal with it. But if they see these beautiful messages of hope, then that's what they start to focus on.
I think my favorite moment was when Jeff was asking the kids to think about, you know, what one word would they send to somebody else to give them that hope, and the conversations that sort of sparked between him and the kids based on that.
Sure. Love can do more than bad.
Love could do more than bad. That's really, really powerful.
Stars are symbolic of hope, and that, like, even though it is a harder time than usual, that it will get better back to what it was before the storm.
I really loved how the older kids learned all the information first from Jeff and what he brought to the initial presentation, and then they were the leaders and teachers of not only their buddies but also the pre-Ks and second graders. I think it's important, if we are going to try to raise leaders, we have to give kids many more opportunities to lead. They can handle it and they can do it very well, and this project really brought that to light.
Okay, everyone here is going to paint a star, and you can add a word or just do a really nice picture. And they're going to send it to a place that had a fire or a tornado or a hurricane. So when people see them, they'll lift their day and know there is always hope happening.
An important role, and that they can make a difference in the lives of other people using their words, using the power of their words.
Some words that we wrote were like joy, don't worry, stay strong, believe, shine bright, smile, words that would make you feel better.
I wrote faith because I wanted to faith in themselves and faith in the fact that they can rebuild.
Watching all the children sit and take time with one another to think of a word, a term, something that they knew would directly affect someone else.
Okay, so I went over to help him and he said, Miss Smith, there's thousands of words in the world, thousands of words, so I need to pick just one. It's really hard. Can you help me with that?
I think the importance of this kind of service learning and kids having hands-on activities to go along with it is very important. And they really do get, you know, some idea that we're giving these stars to somebody else. They may not understand all the aspects of it, but it is fostering that empathetic viewpoint, putting yourself in somebody else's shoes and really saying, hey, we can give them hope, or we could give them strength, and that's a very important message.
Our students had a babysitter whose home country had went through a natural disaster, and the kids during an indoor recess period decided to take paper out and made their version of Stars of Hope. It was a good experience. We had a couple of kids who took what we learned from the assembly and made it their own.
This is really amazing. The kids are doing such a great job, and my fourth grade leaders are better teachers than anybody I know.
The year talking about ourselves and talking about what we had within ourselves to make ourselves more confident, to make ourselves stronger. And it's just nice to see them come outside of themselves, to be more aware of one another.
Gave the kids an opportunity to take themselves out of their own environment right here, find out about other things that are happening throughout the country where people need to have hope.
It's amazing their messages of hope and love that they're sharing.
I think it will lift their spirits and make them feel happy and make them smile and have a positive attitude.
It also, this particular project came from a child. So for me to find something that came out of what one child wanted and grew and grew and grew into something so amazing, I think is very powerful because it is in the voice of young children where we find these ideas that are possible. They don't think anything is not possible.
Everybody, everybody wants to love. Everybody, everybody wants to be loved. Love, love, oh, just let the love, love, love begin. Everybody, everybody wants to love. Everybody, everybody wants to be loved. Love.